So, in the last class, we have completed our first part one, second lesson. Ninth class. Part two, second lesson. The natural release of the earth. So in the last class we have started this lesson part one. Now part two. So the natural release means I already told you that the landforms, the surface, the terrain of the earth is divided into some parts, and every part is having certain particular name. And the land, from the changes which have taken in the land from olden days, from ancient days to nowadays, from lakhs of years ago, from up to now. So, and I told you that there was only one land and one water body in the olden days. So here, the only one land is Pangaea. This land was the time is moving, going on. The movement in the land happened, and the land was divided into some pieces. That means some parts. So going on from the ancient days to nowadays, we saw so many changes, and the sizes, shapes of the lands is also changing from modern days to nowadays. So the present, at what shape we are seeing in the maps. So that is the shape is not it is a temporary shape, but it is not the permanent shape. In the coming years also, maybe the shapes of the land maybe also change, maybe can also change. Maybe the lands can also move from one place to another place. But it will take a huge time. That means a huge time of period. That means maybe millions of years, hundred of years, we can say. But this process won't happen. This process won't happen in 1 month or two years or 3 years. This process will take much time. So here, the next, in the last class we have stopped the jigsaw puzzle. Jigsaw puzzle means I already told you that the puzzle. Puzzle means, what is the meaning of puzzle? Puzzle means it is like a question. It is like confusion. We can't say what will happen. So here, jigsaw puzzle means the land is changing its shape and size according to the time. So this is like a puzzle. All the scientists thought that the movement of the land, the changing of the land is like a puzzle, and this puzzle is named as jigsaw. So here, in the last class we have discussed that what is jigsaw puzzle. So here, I already told you that there is only one land, one water body, and along with this, in the changings of the land, in the dividing of the land, in this puzzle, going on after few years, Pangaea land divided into some land pieces. So each piece is noted as a plates here. So all the land plates are named particular plates, particular names. There are six major land plates and two minor plates. So what are the six major plates? First we will see. First one is Africa. Second one is North America. third one is South America. Next, fourth one is, what is fourth one? Indo Australian. Indo-Australian. This is the fourth. Next, fifth one is Eurasia. Eurasia. And last, sixth one is Pacific. So here, children, teacher, you told that all the things, all the my plates are called as land, but you wrote here Pacific. Pacific is a ocean. Here, Pacific is also related to the earth surface, but it is not another thing which we written here, the thing which is away from the surface. It is not the away from the surface, it is one of the part of the surface of the earth. So these are the six major plates. Africa, you know the Africa, but in that time the shape of the Africa is somewhat different. Second one, North America, you know, or South America, you know, Indo-Australian. In that time, Indonesia and Australia was combined, but now it was divided into some other continents. So, Eurasia, now it is called as Europe. Next one, Pacific. In the Pacific, we can also discuss about the poles also, Arctic and Antarctic also. Minor means Nazca. Minor plates are Nazca and Arabia. Both these are the two minor plates, Nazca and Arabia. So these all are the plates of the land which was discovered by the invented by the scientist. So all these are. Next. So next one, volcanoes. Volcanoes means, you know already that. So we have discussed that the three layers of the earth. So this is a crust, first part. This is a mantle. This is inner core and the outer core. So here we already discussed that mantle and core are the liquid form of the part which is present inside the earth, and why these parts are in the form of liquid means these are in the form of liquid. Why? Because there is a lot of heat inside the earth. So we know that if a thing gets a heat means automatically it will change its form from the solid to the liquid. So in the same way, here mantle is like a liquid. So coming to here, so this is a mountain. This is a mountain. Here this is a mountain, and this is a crust. This is a crust, and this is the magma. Magma is a part which is a flowing liquid, hot liquid. So hot fluid, this one magma, and this magma is related and attached to the mantle part and the crust part. So this magma which is present here, this is the fluid which is very hot, always boiling and very hot. So this magma will come out from the mountain in the form of a hot, by making a way, and it will comes out this in this way. it will comes out. Here this magma will come out in the at the top part of the mountain. So here while coming out, this magma will make some scratches on the mountain. These scratches are called side vent, and the upper part which is here is called as central vent. So central vent, side vent and magma, and this is the volcano lava which is coming out from the mountain. Maybe this lava can also come, it can also come in the form of ash, in the form of fire, in the form of bombs, volcano bombs. And sometimes it can also come out in the form of hot liquid or hot fluid. In these so many ways it will come out. So coming is in some positions, the magma which is present inside under the crust, it may be formed in a solid form because of the differences in the temperature. Because of the temperature coolingness, this magma which is present here will change from the hot fluid to the solid. A thing which is changing from liquid to solid because of the low temperature and coolingness, cold. So here this is changing into the solid form, stones are. So these stones are called as, which are inside the mountain, these mountains are changing in the changing into hot liquid, into the solid stones. Because of the differences in the temperature, these solids are called as intrusive. These stones are called as intrusive. And after coming out this magma out in the form of volcano lava, after coming out this fluid is come. So children, here volcanoes, we have discussed up to now volcanoes, no? These type of volcanoes we can see in the Mediterranean Sea. So the Mediterranean Sea volcanoes are called as strong body. These volcanoes are called as strong body. So after that, Pacific. Pacific ring of fire. So why we are discussing about the water body, which is the largest one in our world. So here so this is the part on the globe. Normally we will see that North America, South America, Europe, Africa, Asia and Australia. So this is the front part of the globe or our earth. So by going to the up of the earth, that means here North America to Asia, no? So in the same way, back side, Asia to North America, the back side. So there is a Pacific ring. There is a Pacific Ocean. Pacific Ocean. So why we are discussing why the Pacific Ocean is like a fire. So here the part of facing here, the back side of the globe, from east to west, this is the very dangerous volcanic place. Pacific Ocean here. So we can travel from the front side, from west to east, North America to Asia, but from back side Asia to North America, we can't travel. Why? Because we can't change the we can't change the destination here. Why? Because there is a dangerous volcanoes which are always in the Pacific Ocean. That's why this is called as Pacific Ring of Fire. Here in this ocean, in this Pacific area, in the Pacific Ocean, there will be in the this is the border of the Pacific Ocean, and this is also the border of the big volcanoes, which are very dangerous, which are always used to come out the lava. This is Pacific Ring of Fire. This is called as Pacific Ring of Fire. So that's why in the plates, in the topic of jigsaw puzzle, we have discussed Pacific is also one of the plate which is acting as a particular volcanoes lava, and it is also a largest water body. So this is also having the fire producing volcanoes here. So now we will discuss that how does the flow in the ocean will be spreaded. The spreading of the flow inside the ocean is happening because of the volcanoes itself. So there also will be so many volcanoes inside the oceans or seas. When the volcanoes, the lava come out, at that time the stones which are now we discussed igneous stones which are present, the stones which are falling around the volcano these stones are falling in with a different colors. So these are also having the layers of the hot fluid on them. So by these, the spreading of the flow is happening by the water is spreading towards the land, and then the volcanoes, when the lava is coming out, then automatically the stones, the floor inside the ocean will be spreading. So these, the water and the floor is also getting scratches inside the floor. In these scratches, the water is entering, and these cracks are not again attaching each other. That's why the spreading inside the ocean is happening, but we can't see out from the outside. So in this way, the spreading of the floor inside the ocean is happening, but we can't see any changes outside. But the volcanoes are also occurring inside the ocean. The spreading of the ocean is happening because of the volcanoes, the lava, the stones which are coming out, then they are spreading around the volcano. So in this way the floor inside the ocean or sea, both of them are same, sea or ocean is spreading inside the floor because of the volcanoes. So in the next class, 9th class students, in the next class we will discuss the next topics like external features of the earth and etc. So 9th class students, all of you must take your textbook in front of you, maintain the running notes, mark the important points. So 9th class, up to now we have completed the second part. Okay, in the third part we will continue the next question. Thank you.